Alan Gross, shown here on a trip to Jerusalem, was arrested in Cuba exactly 5 years ago while working as a subcontractor for the American government. He was sentenced to 15 years in jail for building internet access for locals that bypassed official censorship. The Cuban authorities saw that as subversive. During the trial, his wife Judy appealed for release on humanitarian grounds. More recently, Mr. Gross suggested he'd kill himself if he wasn't set free soon. It's a warning that visiting U.S. senators took seriously.
Senator Udall and I had the opportunity to meet with Alan while we were in Havana. I won't characterize that discussion any further than to say that he really wants to come home. After 5 years, he wants and needs to come home.
But Havana has long demanded the release of convicted Cuban spies held in the U.S. for more than 16 years.
Y este sería el primer gesto.
This would be the most important gesture the U.S. could make to start normalizing relations, and it's in the capacity of President Obama to take this decision. If Alan Gross is still in Cuba, it's because Obama hasn't taken the necessary step to give our three comrades back. If he did, Gross will immediately return to America.
A prisoner exchange might signal that internal politics in both countries are making it easier to move towards a resumption of diplomatic relations. Whatever the case, many observers argue that current conditions offer the best chance in decades for an end to half a century of conflict. Barbara Plett-Usher, BBC News, Havana.